हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व चैप्टर नंबर 2 प्रैक्टिस सेट 2.2 ऑफ क्लास एट मैथमेटिक्स. सो हियर यू कैन सी द पेज ऑफ प्रैक्टिस सेट 2.2. आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज चूज द करेक्ट ऑल्टरनेटिव्स. इन दैट फर्स्ट सब क्वेश्चन इज इन द एडजॉइनिंग फिगर इफ लाइन एम इज पैरेलल लाइन एन एंड लाइन पी इज अ ट्रांसवर्सल then find the value of x and the options are given. First option is 135 degree, option B is 90 degree, option C is 45 degree and option D is 40 degree. So let us see the solution for this question. So in the figure we have 3x and x, and we know that 3x and x both are interior angles pair. So here we can use the property of interior angle. So we know that two parallel line and their transversal form an interior pair. The sum of interior pair is 180 degrees. So here, therefore, we can find the sum for 3x and x, which is 180 degrees. So 3x and 1x will be 4x is equals to 180 degrees. So we will get the value of x is equals to 180 degrees divided by 4. It means value of x will be 4 ones are 4, 4 fours are 16, 2 will be remain, so you will get 45. So value of x will be 45 degree. It means our option C is correct answer. Our second question is, in the adjoining figure, if line A is parallel to line B and line L is transversal, then find the value of x. And the options are option A 90 degree, option B 60 degree, option C 45 degree and option D is 30 degree. Let us see solution. In this figure, directly we cannot see any relation between angle 4x and angle 2x. But we can find this angle easily because this angle is the vertical opposite angle of 2x. So that is why this angle will be 2x. So now we get the interior pair of angles and we can use the property of interior angle here, which is the sum of pair of interior angle is equals to 180 degree. So we can write 4x plus 2x is equals to 180 degree. The reason for this pair of interior angle. And the pair of interior angle measures 180 degree. So 4x plus 2x is equals to 6x is equals to 180 degree. So value of x will be 180 degree divided by 6. It means value of x is equals to 30 degree. So option D is correct, which is 30 degree. Question number 2 is, in the adjoining figure line P parallel line Q, line T and line S are transversal. Find measure of angle X and angle Y using the measure of angles given in the figure. So in this figure, line P is parallel to line Q and line T and line S both are transversals. So we have to find the value for X and value for Y also. So let us consider this angle is angle Z. So now here we get the linear pair angle. Why we choose this is linear pair? Because angle Z and angle 40 degree both are corresponding angles. So easily we will get the value of X. Consider angle Z shown in the figure. So measure of angle Z is equals to 40 degree. Why? Because they are corresponding angles. So therefore angle X plus angle Z is equals to 180 degree because they are in linear pair. So therefore, एंगल x प्लस 40 डिग्री इज इक्वल्स टू 180 डिग्री बिकॉज 40 डिग्री इज द मेजर ऑफ एंगल z. सो एंगल x इज इक्वल्स टू 180 डिग्री माइनस 40 डिग्री. सो वी विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ और द मेजर ऑफ एंगल x इज इक्वल्स टू 140 डिग्री. नाउ वी विल फाइंड द मेजर ऑफ एंगल y हियर. सो फॉर दैट वी विल कंसिडर दिस एंगल. सो सपोज दिस एंगल इज एंगल w. सो कंसिडर लेट कंसिडर एंगल w शोन इन द फिगर. बिकॉज एंगल w एंड एंगल 70 दे आर फॉर्मिंग अ लीनियर पेयर एंड हियर एंगल y एंड एंगल w they are alternate angles. So we know that the measure of alternate angle is always equal. Therefore measure of angle w plus 70 degree is equals to 180 degree because they are forming linear pair. So that is why measure of angle w will be 180 degree minus 70 degree. It means measure of angle w is equals to 110 degree. And here angle w is equals to angle y because they are alternate angle and therefore angle y is equals to 110 degree because it is equals to angle w which is alternate angle for angle y. Question 3 is, in the adjoining figure, line P is parallel to line Q. Line L is parallel to line M. Find measure of angle A, angle B and angle C using the measure of given angles and justify your answer. Here, line P is parallel line Q and line L are transversal. Line L is parallel to line M. And line P is a transversal. And third, line P is parallel to line Q and line M is transversal. So firstly, let us find the measure of angle A. So line P is parallel to line Q and line L are transversal. So that is why measure of angle A plus 80 degree is equals to 180 degree because they are interior angles. So measure of angle A is equals to 180 degree minus 80 degree. So we will get measure of angle A is equals to 100 degree. Now let us take line L is parallel to line M where line P is a transversal. So therefore measure of angle C is equals to 80 degree because these are the exterior alternate angles. And line P is parallel to line Q. And line M is transversal. So measure of angle B is equals to measure of angle C because they are corresponding angles. So therefore measure of angle B will be 80 degree
from equation 1.
So measure of angle A is equals to 100 degree measure of angle B is equals to 80 degree and measure of angle C is equals to again 80 degree.
Question number 4. In the adjoining figure, line A is parallel line B. Line L is transversal. find measure of angle x, angle y and angle z using the given information.
So here given things are line A is parallel to line B and line L is transversal. So angle x will be 105 degree because it is a corresponding angle and we know that corresponding angle measures are always equal. So now we have measure of angle y is equal to measure of angle x because they are vertically opposite angles. Again, vertically opposite angles are always equal. So measure of angle y will be 105 degree.
This we get from equation 1.
Like that way, measure of angle z plus angle 105 degree is equal to 180 degree because they are forming a linear pair here. So therefore, measure of angle z is equal to 180 degree minus 105 degree. So we will get measure of angle z is equal to 75 degree. So therefore, measure of angle x is 105 degree measure of angle y is 105 degree and measure of angle z is equals to 75 degree.
Last question is question number 5. In the adjoining figure, line P is parallel to line L, L is parallel to line Q. Find angle X with the help of measures given in the figure. This is very easy question to solve. You can easily solve it. Here line P is parallel to line L and line L is parallel to line Q. We have to find the angle X. So let us consider angle X is alternate angle for angle 40 degree. So therefore angle A we will get 40 degree because this is the alternate angle for 40 degree. Alternate angle for angle 40 degree. Like that way let us consider angle B is alternate angle for angle 30 degree. So therefore we will get angle B is equals to 30 degree because this is alternate angle for angle 30 degree. Now angle X is equals to angle A plus angle B, right? This is our angle A and this is angle B. We have considered that angle A is alternate angle for 40 degree and angle B is alternate angle for 30 degree. Now we will get angle X is equals to 40 degree plus 30 degree. It means measure of angle X is equals to 70 degree. So therefore measure of angle X is equals to 70 degree. So here we have completed practice set 2.2. If you want PDF file of this exercise, you can check description box. You will get it easily and you can use it. So students, thanks for watching.